Yeah?
Okay, who wants to start off with the first question? Let's go, Calvin.
My name's Christy Provolsek. I've been at St Albans East Primary School for 6 months now. I'm a first year graduate and I have grade 3/4.
This one's really easy. How much chocolate are they going to get?
The whole.
One whole bar. They're going to be pretty lucky and get one whole chocolate bar. Okay. Picture's pretty easy. How are we going to do this in numbers? How are we going to use numbers to represent this? Now, look back at our learning intention. We can use whole numbers, fractions, or decimals. Are they going to get 50%? What are they going to get?
A whole.
A whole, which is known as?
100%.
Okay, 100%. Now, you can represent it any way that you want.
Yes.
But now we need to put it in words. How can we tell a story about this chocolate bar?
I'm Anne-Marie Kleiman, principal at St Albans East Primary School, a school located in the western suburbs of Melbourne. We have 365 children here who come from a very diverse background, predominantly Asian population and extremely low socioeconomic. When employing a proficient teacher, I'm looking for those that can use the knowledge that they've gained about their students to plan explicit programs that are going to meet their individual needs.
In the classroom and in meetings, we observe our data that we get from student pre-assessment activities. With that information, then we base our lessons around what the students need rather than the content, so it's specific to children, and then using differentiating groups to work out different activities for each group.
How many are you going to give to Dennis first?
You're
going to give him two? Two strips. Let's go. One for you. How many are you going to get? Okay, I want one, and our imaginary friend wants one too. Good. Now there's only two left. Isn't it? What are we going to do with these? What do you think a good strategy to do with these would be?
In my maths lessons, I encourage students to use concrete materials. So for example, having the visual of a real life chocolate bar and then photocopying that onto a sheet where they can physically cut the chocolate out and share it evenly between their groups. We do a lot of hands-on, so the children are provided with that visual and that opportunity.
Do you want to share your story? Yes?
Darren got two chocolate bars and shared them with his three friends, including himself. And then how much did they each get?
Oh, so you've got a nice little question in there too. Good work.